Welcome to clickmeproject.com. Hello, this is our project title, Deceptive Attack and Defense Scheme in Honeypot Enabled Networks for the Internet of Things. Then this is our project abstract. The problem of defending and against attacks in Honeypot Enabled Networks by looking at a game theoretical model of deception involving an attackers and a defenders. The attackers may try to deceive the defenders by deploying different types of attacks, ranging from a suspicious to seemingly normal activity, while the defender in turn can make use of honeypot as a tool of deception to trap attackers. The problem is modeled as a Bayesian game of incomplete information, where equilibria are identified for both the one-shot game and the repeated game versions. The frequency of active attackers, above which players will take deceptive action, and below which the defender can mix his or her strategy while keeping the attacker's success rate low. And this is our project flow diagram. And first collect the entries data, which is used by the user, and collection of the entry data, and then pre-process the data if it is having any error or irrelevant data which is in the data set, and clear the data from the data set. And after the clearing, the pre-process will be completed. After the pre-process will be completed, then find abnormal events. Abnormal events derived from the whole data of the data set which is used by the user collected entries. Then we have to classify the abnormal events from the normal events. Then classify the active and passive users using the gaming theory. The Bayesian gaming theory is used to find out the passive users of passive attackers or defenders. So we have to classify the passive users and active users from the whole data set. Then view the report. The view the report sensor on the number of active users and the passive users, or which is in the report. And we have to view the report and assign the active users if it is active users, we have to assign the directly assign to the regular system. If it is any passive users or any users, we have to redirect the honeypot and store the port address of the user. Then close the program. Now we are going to see the demo of our project. First, click home.java and right click on it and choose run file option. After choosing the run file option, the home screen of the project will be run and the device display in the screen, display in the window. Then click start button to start into our system, which is Deceptive Honeypot system. Then after starting the system, we have to collect the data from the data file. Collect the data from the dotpart data set. We have to insert the dotpart data set, which is used for the intrusion and user detection. And then open the data set. We have to select the data set from the local drive and then load the data set into the database. It takes several minutes to insert thousands of data to insert the data, and the data loaded successfully. Then click and the data will be loaded successfully. Then the thousands and thousands of data are inserted into the database. Then click next button to data pre-processing. Now we have to view the inserted data, which is it's a raw data. We have to review the raw data, then press pre-processing the data. Then after clicking the pre-processing the data, it has the loading several minutes to analyze the data, and we have to clean the null values or irrelevant records, and then pre-process successfully, and the pre-process data will be displayed in the screen. Then click next button. Now we can detect the abnormal events. Now view the data, view the pre-processed data, and we have taking several threshold attributes to classify the abnormal events acted by the user. it's in reclassified, then it's in, and we store in the abnormal events. Now we have to view the abnormal events, then click next button to view the next abnormal event reports. We have to view the event reports of the abnormal. So total records are 38,664, and the abnormal events are 2,950, and then normal events are remaining normal events. Then we have to click next button to classify the active and the passive users. Now to find the active users using the kinematic theory, the basic Bayesian kinematic theory, we have to find out the active users. The active users will be taking several minutes to find out the results. Then after analyzing the result, we have to find out the active users, and we have to find out the passive users. The passive users are defined as the attackers of the system, so we have to store in the passive users. Now the number of passive users are 34,000 something. So now we move the passive users, active users to regular system. They can use the regular system if he or she is active users. Now we have to view the passive user. The passive users are something displayed in the screen, values are displayed in the screen, and then this will be moved to the honeypot system. They will be redirected successfully. Then next, and view honeypot, and then view honeypot, the honeypot values, then store the port address. I have to store the port address. Then click next button. Then now we have to repeat attack and defense scheme under observation error. We have to calculate the false positive, false negative, true positive, and true negative values. We have to calculate the final. We have to calculate the, find out the false positive, and click the calculate button to false negative, and click the this calculate button to true positive, and click this button to true negative. After completing the find out the values of the system, then get the report, the finalized report, and we have to the evaluation report and the final performance report. After clicking the evaluation report, we have to now it's will be bar chart display in the screen. So the attackers and the defenders. So the detection will be this much of the detection and this much of the attackers. The attackers is the detection attackers more than the detection, and then get the performance results, the comparison performance results of the existing system and the proposed system. So we have to the performance will be higher, slightly increase in the proposed system. Then close the program and thanks to listen.